Hello everybody, this is Asagi 704 and I am back with some thoughts on the new Nintendo 3DS. And of course this is North America, so we only got the XL, which is a shame because I might have sprung for the smaller model had they released it in some fashion over here. But they didn't, so you know, what are you going to do, right? So I sprung for this because of the I got a good deal on it, got 50% off, trading in the previous model XL that I already had. And I have to say, just up front, I'm actually very impressed with this new Nintendo 3DS with the day or so I've had with it, and I used it quite a bit yesterday, and some today. And my thoughts. First, yes, I got the red one because the red and black is the colors that we're getting over here at the moment, and I think the red looks very nice. It's a nice deep red. Looks very good. I like it. So to get on to the changes and what I think about them, first we have things like the a lot of the functions and the accessibility to different things on the system are all now up front on the lower half instead of where they used to be. So the game cartridge is now here, front left, and the used to be back here, but it's not anymore. The stylus is right here. So it used to be over here on the right. The power button is now right here. That used to be on the inside bottom panel. And the headphone jack is still in the front. It's just on the center instead of slightly off to the left, I believe, is what it was before. And, of course, we have also the SD card. Originally, it was... Previously, it was a large size SD card, the normal size, standard size, whatever you want to call it, and it was accessible through this, through here, this right here, a flap here. Now you have to remove the entire back panel with these screws to get to it, which then ends up being right around here on the inside, because it's a micro SD now. I don't know why they couldn't make that fit somewhere accessible with like they did before, but whatever. It's not like I'm going to change it much, or if ever, so that's fine with me. I really don't care too much. Of course, another thing that's changed is that this is where the volume is now. It used to be a slider, I think, right here, somewhere like right around here on the left bottom panel. Now it's on the upper left side of the screen, and the 3D dial slash slider still same place as always was. It's about the only thing that hasn't changed. So getting that out of the way, we open it up, and overall I think it's basically roughly very, very close to the same size as the original 3DS XL, though it feels a slightly more compact, but maybe that's just my mistake, and I don't know what I'm talking about, but it feels a little bit easier to grip the controls, like on the D-pad here, and get the top buttons on the side here. And that's another thing that's changed, of course, as a lot of people know. There's the additional shoulder buttons in addition to the originals, which are L and R. Now you have the ones inside here, Z, L, and ZR, and they're easily accessible with the normal grip. It's very simple. You just hit them with a tip. If you want, need to get them, either one, it works good. It's good placement. They work. They feel good. Obviously, the standard suite of controls that the other models of 3DS previously had are all still here. Of course, circle pad, D-pad, four face buttons. The start and select, though, before, at least on the XL, was start was here and select was here and home was in the center. I do prefer it coming back to the old DSi placement of right below the face buttons. It's much easier to get to. You have to strain to reach way over here because it just feels weird. And the home button's still here, of course, in the center, as you can see, and that still works fine for that because you're not going to access it too often. But start is pretty often pushed, and you know, kind of want it in a better place, and that's a much better place. Of course, one of the other new things is the C-stick. It's right here. Looks like, you know, one of those little nubs from old laptops. I don't even think any of them have them anymore. Any laptops have them, but I could be wrong. It's been a long time since I've ever had a laptop that had one, but it works generally well. You know, it's not great, as it looks like it wouldn't be that great, but I don't think it's going to be too bad. It actually works in the UI as well. You can use it to move your cursor around. So I haven't used it a lot in actual games, though, so remains to be seen how great it is, but it probably is serviceable enough and probably not too terrible. I think it's better to have it than to have to rely on a stupid bulky add-on with the CirclePad Pro. So, and this takes advantage of everything that already previously, before the system existed, took advantage of the CirclePad Pro. And this also can use CirclePad Pro and act as that, so it's pretty nice. So I guess I'll turn it on here. And one of my favorite things about it is how much I enjoy the additional horsepower behind the hood for just the UI. It makes it a lot snappier, it's a lot more responsive, and that's just something I really, really think is great. Because the previous models were just too slow and sluggish for me. They would take like an extra couple seconds or something. I just didn't like. So I'll go to the friends list real quick. And you can see it doesn't take very long. It's a few seconds. And you can go out. So that's neat. Exiting takes virtually no time. So it's really great because it took a lot longer before. So I really like that the hardware is used to make it much snappier, much nicer in that way. Also, yeah, the other thing I really like, of course, is how the new... See, I was not a big fan of... I'm not a fan of stereoscopic 3D. I think it's a waste of time. I generally don't think it's a worthy cost, especially for, you know, something like a PS3 games that use it, where you have to have your own glasses and your own TV that can access it. So at least this system, as always, it has, you know, glasses-free 3D, which is nice. Though I still don't think it's a worthy addition to video gaming, I think it's largely useless, because it really doesn't add anything. You know, a game is still going to be good with or without it if it's a good game. It's not really going to make it better. At least it won't ever take a mediocre or bad game and to make it a great game or even a good game. It's a nice accent, but that's about it as far as I'm concerned. And but I do, having said that, what they're calling on the box Super Stable 3D, which is referring to the camera up here, now tracks your face to keep the 3D effect going, you know, for your eyes and within a specific, you know, set distance and whatnot. You know, obviously you can't go forever off to the screen and, you know, in some crazy angles, because obviously you will lose it. But generally, I've noticed it's actually been very good at keeping up with, you know, the little bit of movement that you tend to have when you use a portable system like this, and it always kept it in line and kept the effect going. It was really good. Generally, I felt like I was playing Super Hang-On, as you can see, a 3D Super Hang-On here, and it was good for the game. I liked the effects for the game, and it It just kept it going for anything I was really playing, whether it was that or Tetris or whatever. So generally I think that addition works pretty well and is definitely worth it, especially if you actually think much higher of a 3D effect and you like the 3D more than me. It's a nice gimmick, but it's, you know, certainly not going to make or break any game, whether it's done well or not. So generally, my overall opinion is that this is definitely worthy of a pickup, especially since I got it for 50% less than the asking price of $200 because of that trade-in deal I got. So that's the main reason I got it right away, because of that trade-in deal. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have got it for quite a while, if not ever. I don't really know. I didn't have a contingent plan. I just was thinking, well, you know, if I can get a similar deal that I got with the DSi back when that came out for a trade-in of my older system, I'd probably do it, and lo and behold, that happened. So yeah, I think this is actually very nice. It's definitely it remains to be seen whether or not, you know, the added hardware in here will be taken advantage of by, you know, game developers and publishers, because they will have to make games specifically for this system to do it, and that splits the user base and thus the sales, most definitely. So it remains to be seen whether anything really would make use of the many games will make use of the hardware. But even if there isn't, I still think it's a worthy upgrade. But if you already have a system, probably, if you're going to end up paying full price, probably wait and see what kind of deals you can get later on down the line for maybe holiday season, Christmas season, or something like that, you know, because I would not have gotten this, as I've already stated, if I had to pay full price, since it wasn't too terribly long ago that I got a 3DS XL originally. So that's my opinion. I think it's worth it, and if you can get a good deal on it. And, yeah. Thanks for watching.